everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find the symmetric equations of a line. In our problem, we're given a point P and a vector V, and our line is represented by the point and the vector. So it's passing through this point P, 2, 3, negative 4, and the vector represents these direction numbers here. So we're going to find the symmetric equations of the line that's represented by these two things here. And the way that we're going to do that, this is a fairly easy concept if we have the right information, and in this case we do. So the formula that we're going to be using is the following. We have x minus x sub 0 divided by a, and the corresponding formulas for the y and z symmetric equations. They're just over b and c. So our problem gives us the point P and the vector V, and inside here, the point P, 2, 3, and negative 4 represent x sub 0, y sub 0, and z sub 0, respectively. And our vector V, inside here, we have our direction numbers A, B, and C. So A is equal to 1, B is equal to negative 1, and C is equal to negative 2. And that's always going to be the case. You're always going to plug in the three points here in the three direction numbers inside of your vector for A, B, and C, and the three points here inside of your point P for x sub 0, y sub 0, and z sub 0. So let's go ahead and plug those in. That's going to be the solution to our problem. We plug in each of those points, and then all we do from here is simplify to get our final answer. And maybe it's simplified enough already, but in our case, we have some simplification to do, and that's going to give us our final answer. Obviously, the 1 here in the denominator is going to go away. That's redundant. We don't need it. The negative 1 in the denominator here is going to flip the sign on both the y term and the negative 3 term. So instead of y minus 3, we're going to end up with negative y plus 3. And for our symmetric equation here in z, we're going to bring this negative on the denominator out in front of the fraction, and we're going to combine this double negative here into a positive. So we're going to end up with negative z plus 4 divided by 2. And that's it. That's all we have to do. It's just basically plugging in and simplifying as long as you're given enough information up here in the original problem. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!